My name is Nick Nosler, and I'm a meteorologist at the National Interagency Coordination Center. Predictive Services is an integrated group that synthesizes fire information, resource information, and weather information to provide an outlook and weather briefing for fire management. We provide briefings and intel for many of the fire management officers for the various land agencies. With our information, hopefully we provide them enough confidence in making sound decisions for resource allocation and other decisions regarding fire management. We use a lot of data. We have weather data, and that involves observational data, weather model data, and that's satellite, radar, surface stations, and then we also have fuels and fire danger information. So fire danger kind of combines weather and fuels to provide us an outlook of where it's dry, where is the vegetation most likely to have an ignition and be receptive to fire spread. And that's just one part of it. We also have the other part, which looks at all the different resources, whether it's aircraft, crews, engines, all the different positions that help fire management throughout the nation. So we combine all this information together to provide an outlook of where we think it's going to get busy, where we think it might get slower. That way they can move resources to mount a better response. Historical data is very important in our outlooks and our forecasts. It provides the backbone for our models and kind of gives us perspective on what we've seen before and how the current situation relates to that. So using that data, we train our models, and then with those models, we forecast where we think significant fire potential is going to increase and where we might see an increase of fire activity. That way we can give the decision makers, fire managers, the necessary information for them to do their jobs. Yeah, fuels are integral. It's the foundation of everything that we do. Fuel sampling, fire danger calculations, all of that goes into our outlooks, into our models. It's the most important thing because if you don't have receptive fuels, you don't have dry vegetation, then there's probably not much to worry about. So if we have a good grasp on what fuels are, then we can start adding weather components, we can start adding the other components that comes from intel to do our jobs more effectively and to help out the fire managers do their jobs more effectively. The National Office works with the GACs quite closely. So we have daily briefings with them, daily coordination calls, and they provide a lot of the information that we use at the national level, pretty much all of the information. If we don't get it from them, it's really difficult to cobble together our intel reports, our fire potential reports, and our fire danger information as well. What we do is kind of coordinate and put together everything into one cohesive picture at the national level. That way, we can make decisions at kind of a 50,000 foot view while they're more at like a 10 or 20,000 foot view. So each one of the GACs, the Predictive Services Units, issues significant fire potential outlooks during their fire seasons. Some of these can be year-round, other ones are seasonal. And these are essentially giving you an idea of where significant fire potential is increasing. And when I talk about significant fire potential, that is essentially a large fire that's going to require a large amount of resources to suppress or monitor it. Those are issued daily. We also have our monthly and seasonal outlooks. These are what we look at long-range forecasting current trends in fire activity, current trends in fire danger and fire potential to see, are we going to be above normal or above average in terms of fire activity for the next month, 2 months, 3 months, or even 4 months. These are very integral for strategic planning at the national level and also regional levels to see, do we need to keep crews on longer? Is there going to be an increased demand for teams outside of the core fire season? So these are also integral parts of what we do here with our monthly and seasonal outlooks. Being a fire weather meteorologist and working in predictive services, it's a great job. It's actually probably my dream job. You know, working in an integrated group like Predictive Services, you use your expertise to put together information that is very important for the national perspective. And when we provide good information and good outlooks and good forecasts, that helps decision makers at national and regional levels do their jobs, which is very important because then that helps the firefighters on the ground who are doing their jobs do it more effectively and safely.